Hi, for today's video, a quick look at this. It is a piece of circuit board I found on German eBay in military overstock category, I believe, if I remember correctly. And it was 20 euros. Not cheap for just a circuit board, but obviously it is quite interesting. So little slot in the board with a retainer bracket here, connector here to go in the main board, and it is branded everywhere from Lucas Aerospace. So here is the part number for you. Google did not have anything about it. And serial number. So the main features of interest are obviously those big golden blocks. So you can notice the part number here starts with 777, and on to those modules also. So we have here obviously golden hybrid modules of almost space grade. Look at this big one here. So this one has this part number, or this here we might have the dead code, so 83 84. It is consistent with the other dead codes I did find. So we have one of this model with a lot of contacts. The case is golden metal case, so sadly I will not open these ones, obviously, because it is my only board of this kind. But I have a few opened hybrids. I may do a video soon with a microscope, USB microscope look at a few hybrids, but not these ones. The cover are laser welded, it seems. So we have this part. We have two similar ones here, and you will note the part numbers start also with 777. We have one different kind here, and one other here. You will notice, so there is a big black dot here, probably for the pin number one indicator. But this, I have no idea of what it is about. Also, onto the small integrated circuits here. You can see ceramic gold package. And same thing, this AN number starting by 7 and dead code with 83, 84. So, three of them. The other parts are a lot more common. Well, more or less. Metal can, transistors, and probably op amps. Let me check. RN, yes, 741 for this one by Raytheon. Some interesting area here with pads. You can rearrange as you want, it seems. Tuning or configuration pads. A lot of bulge wires with golden magnet wire. Weird, unusual things here, probably capacitors, but not a common design. Some glass body diodes here. Here, super tiny inductors or transformers. Yes, transformers. Very, very tiny, something like 5 millimeters of side. Some old school brown capacitors here, and it is almost all for this board. Trimmer here, which is actually not well secured. You can notice it should vibrate, while everything else is more or less super tight. This is moving around. quite weird. There is no evidence it was replaced at some point. So looks like they did almost forget to put a drop of epoxy or something like this to secure it. Other side, not much. Again, the part number here, but part number for the board itself, for the PCB, not for the wall assembled module. You can see it is not the same number. And it is all the other side of those pads. Seems we have 4-layer PCB. Interesting. Of course, golden terminals here. Some of them have a little bit of a bend. I need to correct them a little bit more. And there is something unusual with this connector. There is some kind of a seal here. They did add over the pins, you can see, it could come off. Not something you see usually. Was this module removed or is it new old stock? It is actually pretty hard to tell. There is no evidence of a removed screw in here, but maybe there was one. Okay, so very nice addition to my collection of unusual electronics. Oh, I did just notice we have some more numbers here on the sides of the modules. Okay, this could go in a frame totally on a wall because it is really a beautiful item. No idea what it is coming out from. This potentiometer here is not aircraft grade secured. By the way, look at this. Really, really not good. So maybe it is some kind of military communications or something like this. But super, super unusual. It is not every day you see a circuit board with five big hybrids on it, which are, by the way, surface mount. Okay, so a very nice collectible item. So thanks for watching. Bye bye.